Bonjour, alors on est toujours dans le cadre des auditions d'Amazon, des travailleurs d'Amazon. Et là, maintenant, donc, nous sommes avec Daniela Usnova, qui travaille à Amazon en Slovaquie. Et nous avons Juraj qui va nous aider pour la traduction d'anglais au Slovaque. D'abord, je vais demander à Daniela de se présenter. Hi Daniela, hi Juraj. First of all, Daniela, can you introduce yourself and tell me since how long time you've been working in Amazon?
Okay, so my name is Daniela. I have been working at Amazon in Slovakia for the past 3 years, and in 2018 I started the union at our distribution center.
And can you tell us what was the lockdown impact on Amazon's business, and if you have experienced an increase in Amazon activity at the beginning of the crisis?
So at first there was an increase in activity, and this was even made worse due to the fact that many workers had to stay at home because the schools were closed, so they had to take paid leave to take care of their children, and therefore Amazon started hiring many more agency workers who are not employees or direct employees of Amazon to cover for the lack of available workforce.
Then have health precautions been implemented by Amazon at your workplace?
So at first it took quite a long time for Amazon to actually implement any serious precautions. At first the workers made their own face masks and had to buy their own gloves to bring to work. They as a union were demanding that there would be a temporary closure of the distribution center for a week so that all the precautions can be made and the whole place can be disinfected, but this was not done. And after about 7 days, the company started providing their own face masks and disinfectant at various places at the distribution center. They also canceled compulsory overtime, which normally there is, but during this period it was only reduced to voluntary overtime. They also instituted, after this period of time, social distancing, so 2 meter distances were marked on the floor of the distribution center so that people knew how far they should stay away from each other. Only after about a month after the government started implementing its own precautions did Amazon start to measure the temperature of everyone who enters the distribution center. So it took some time, but the necessary precautions are in place now. So for example, in the canteen, there is only one person per table. The social distancing is still enforced also in the distribution center itself. So it took some time, but after all, so the precautions were made.
After they were demanding that the place temporarily closes and the company did nothing, they also went to the media and tried to create some pressure to the company. And so after they did this, the company actually provided face masks and gloves.
And you say it took some time, but do you think without the mobilization of the worker, it would have been done?
So the pressure through the media certainly played a part, but maybe even a more important factor was the situation in France with the trial, because after that happened, the company was much more insistent on doing the precautions and also enforcing them at the workplace.
Takže určite, že áno, prispelo aj to Francúzsko k tomu, že začali oveľa rýchlejšie potom manipulovať. A plus aj tá medializácia.
OK, thank you. What was how do you feel with your colleague? How did the worker feel? Were they afraid? Were they fighting, optimistic? What was the atmosphere?
So at first the workers were very discontented with the fact that the company didn't provide them with the necessary personal protective equipment, and that's why they also demanded that the union do something about it, and they were very supportive of the pressure on the media that the union or through the media that the union tried to create. Later, the company instituted a hourly bonus to all workers who came to work, which was €1.50 per hour. And now that bonus was taken away, even though all the precautions are still in place, so people have to still wear their face masks, even though the epidemiological situation in Slovakia is much better now. In fact, there haven't been many new cases for the last few days or weeks, but the company is still enforcing the social distancing rules, also the wearing of the face mask. And so people are now discontent because their bonus was taken away. And so people are angry that the summer is coming and they have to wear these face masks and they don't get any bonus for that.
How do you think these 3 months will affect your working conditions after? Do you think that COVID time will leave its mark on the works organization?
So the precautions that were made during the lockdown or during the quarantine will definitely leave a mark on the working conditions and on the organization of work, because these precautions are still being implemented even though the epidemiological situation has improved. So people still, for example, wear face masks, which is quite exhausting to do that for 10 hours and to work, to have to physically exert yourself while wearing a face mask. It has also been proven that wearing face masks during physical exertion is not very good for one's health. Also, the company is still insisting on enforcing social distancing, which they do through so-called disciplinary letters. And if a person receives, I think, 3 disciplinary letters, they get fired. So anyone who doesn't follow these social distancing rules now received this letter, and it has created much discontent among workers, because it is seen as a very arbitrary disciplinary measure that is used against workers just because they, you know, talk to each other for a short time or something like that. During the lockdown or during the first weeks of the pandemic, the union had an agreement with the company that the disciplinary letters wouldn't be issued for stuff like problems with quality or some minor infractions against the health code and stuff like that, but now the company does not respect the agreement anymore, and they use these disciplinary letters as a disciplinary instrument against the employees. So now the union is planning to send an open letter to the company management and to try to force them to not use these disciplinary letters as a tool against the workers.
Okay, but and do the workers, do you feel stronger after this period, after the fact that the company has to listen to you, has to give you a mask, even if it was after the decision in from the trial in France? But then there were also the debate about the important jobs that are not the ones that are most paid. But so do you think the workers, they feel stronger after that?
So it's quite difficult to say, because on the one hand people complain and they are also very well aware of that the company is not treating them well. But then when there's the question of doing something together, doing a collective action like a strike, then people are afraid to take such action. So and they're unable to really unite and stick together. Some are even afraid to speak to the unionists about the issues. So Daniela gave this example that recently they tried to distribute a survey to the workers about health and safety. And they wanted to find out how are people reacting to this situation during the pandemic, how it impacted their working conditions and personal lives, etc. And so they distributed 1,000 copies of this survey, but they only received about 50 copies back because most people were afraid to participate in the survey.
Okay, and so you told me you heard about the trial of the French workers against Amazon France, and that's how Amazon in Slovakia changed the organization. But do you have links with workers in different countries? And do you have connection and link with workers from other countries in Europe?
So Daniela heard about the trial in France through a newspaper article that someone shared with her. But in terms of international contacts, yes, the union in Sered is a member of a small international network of Amazon workers all over Europe. And Daniela personally participated in an international meeting last year. Of course, there is always the language barrier, which complicates common organizing, but she's trying to follow what colleagues from other countries post online and tries to also inform her co-workers in Slovakia about the struggles that are going on in other countries. And because of this, she also recently got in a bit of trouble because she was sharing this article about the strike of Amazon workers in New York during the pandemic. And the managing director asked to speak to her, and he said she shouldn't spread panic among the workers by sharing such articles.
Okay, so thank you very much. It's been very interesting. And this is going to be my last question. Well, you've just said that the management swayed you. That I feel when you're telling me what is the situation with the workers, that the workers are afraid of Amazon. And can you explain me why they are so afraid of the Amazon, and how can you qualify the way of Amazon stood? And in your opinion, how can you qualify Amazon? And does this company has a responsible attitude? So it's like there is two questions in one. First of all, why the workers do they feel so afraid of Amazon? And how can you qualify the way Amazon stood, but in Slovakia, but also in other countries?
So a major factor that explains why workers are afraid to take action is their fear of losing their jobs. Everyone is also very well aware that Amazon is a company that is hostile to unions. They have felt it ever since they founded the union. So this is also probably a reason why workers are very careful about being associated with unions, because they know that in the eyes of Amazon, the union is an enemy. In terms of how Amazon reacted to the situation, Daniela says they were very late to react. On the positive side, in Slovakia, there haven't been any cases of infections in the distribution center or deaths of workers due to COVID-19, as opposed to other countries. But this is not... This can't really be explained by the precautions that Amazon made. This has more to do with the specific situation in our country and in the precautions that were made by the government. And the situation in other European countries where there have been many infections and as well as deaths, of employees shows just how irresponsibly Amazon has acted throughout this pandemic. Daniela was also saying that the company always insists on the customer being the most important. And she was saying that in times such as these, the workers should be the first or the most important for the company, because without the workers, there are no customers either. So the correct course of action, according to Daniela, would have been to implement closures of distribution centers in Slovakia, but also in other countries, to thoroughly disinfect them and to prepare everything in terms of health and safety precautions, and also to provide bonuses to those workers who were willing to take the risk and to work during the pandemic. Now this bonus was taken away from the Slovak employees, but they still have to work under these safety precautions, which is quite difficult. Daniela was then also mentioning a number of issues that there have been in Amazon in Slovakia also before the pandemic. So things like breaches in health and safety, things like the fact that there is no collective agreement signed between the union and Amazon. They are always trying to postpone this and always trying to maneuver their way out of a collective agreement. There are also cases of Amazon discriminating against people with disabilities in the workplace. And so the way the company reacted during the pandemic is only a continuation of their previous policies. Ale nepreverili si, že aké majú tie pracovné podmienky.
Čiže im stačí len tie papiere. Takže asi tak. Okay, thank you very much. Do you want to add something else?
So Daniela was adding an important technical detail, because originally the center in Sereď in Slovakia of Amazon was a returns center, that they only processed returned packages from other countries. But it is now being changed into a full-scale distribution center, so they will also take care of the deliveries to customers. So this means more work, much more work for the distribution center than before. And finally, she said she's grateful for being able to participate. So thank you for inviting us.
Thank you very much, and we will send you the link of the video, and we keep in touch for after. Thank you very much, Daniela, and thank you very much, Juraj, for the translation.
Dobre, ďakujem.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.